steely and determined Yasmina Siadatan, a force to be reckoned with.
I don't know why you guys are all freaking out the size of the Hummers. What size do you think they were going to be? Stop!
It's almost too to be true.
Bring it on. Let's do it. Great. Got a deal. Thank you very much, my man. I've always wanted to do that.
Oh. Cuddling.
Oh.
At 27, Yasmina is the only candidate with her own business.
She's got the raw business acumen that a lot of other people in this process just don't have. She understands the process of a business from starting up from scratch and bringing it to a success. And I think there is few people here that, you know, understand that.
Yasmina's business skills were rolled out in week two when she led the girls to victory in the city catering task.
I'm happy to be project manager if you guys are happy for me to be project manager.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'll do that for the rest of us, and you don't know your background. What's the experience you've got?
Because I've got my own restaurant, every day I execute delivering, cooking, making, buying, selling food.
Go team leader.
In the catering task, she ran that kitchen with a rod of iron.
I want you all to call me chef. Does anybody want to be in the boardroom losing tomorrow night?
No chef!
Okay, what are we going to do? We're going to win!
Yes, chef!
She was literally running like Gordon Ramsay, so it was really, really funny. And I kind of thought, this girl's quite well put together in a business sense.
Everybody just needs to concentrate on finishing exactly what you're doing. We need to make sure that we're going to be on time for these people, okay?
Fair play to Yasmina, you know, she did an amazing job on that task. The time management that was involved in getting everything spot on, you know, it was really, really well executed.
Brilliant.
I knew from that task that Yasmina was massive competition.
Very well done. A 200% margin, nearly. Even with a few complaints. Very, very well done.
I think Yasmina's business acumen makes her stand out from the others. She won that task because she wasn't afraid to go in really with a low-value product and concentrate on making a profit on it.
I'm suitably impressed, I've got to say. I think you've got your team leader to thank for that, don't you think?
Yes.
Yeah.
It was great to have been project manager and to have won. It was great for Sir Alan to have noticed my skills so early on in the contest.
Yes, yes, go on, yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Is there nothing that you want us to take? You're taking seven items. We're taking
I wonder if you could...
I would think one of her great strengths, setting aside her commerciality, is that she's very structured. She's organised and disciplined in her thoughts.
Ladies, what you aim to do is we want to make a 70% gross profit on whatever we sell.
We could hire her.
1 second, please, right?
I think Yasmina's biggest strength is her biggest weakness as well, is the fieriness.
Lorraine,
for 2 minutes.
No, Lorraine.
Yasmina, let's for 2 minutes. Let me speak.
Lorraine, I'm in the middle of doing something, okay? I let you speak all the time.
No, you didn't.
She needs to harness that temper at times and keep her mouth shut.
This instant.
Can you stop shouting at me, Lorraine, please? You're giving me a headache. I come from a really strong background. Like, my dad's a very strong person, my mum's a very strong person, all my brothers and sisters are very strong.
Born in 1981 to an Iranian father and British mother, Yasmina is one of six children.
When I was growing up, especially because mum had younger children, you had to really fight to get your voice heard. Even the cat had to, like, fight her way to get any food. Literally, it was a case of survival of the fittest.
As a child, Yasmina often helped in her father's restaurant.
She definitely gets her business mind from my ex-husband. He was and still is very much a complete entrepreneur, always pushing things to the limit.
Because my dad is Iranian, I know a lot about the Middle East, and I know a lot about the standard of living over there. So I think I've always been quite grateful that I was born in this country. You have the possibility to be very successful. And so I think I've always wanted to succeed for that reason.
If we want this product exclusive to John Lewis, what does that mean for you?
I would like to put this on the table. If you can guarantee us 20,000 units, if you want to put in that order tomorrow, then we can guarantee you exclusivity.
Well, John Lewis asked for exclusivity, but Yasmina went in far too high. but they have placed an order for 10,000 units on an exclusive basis.
In 2007, Yasmina and older brother Matthew opened their own restaurant, winning an award in the first year.
Yasmina's natural role in our business is definitely being in control. Yasmina loves being in control, without a doubt.
I would like to be project manager. The reason being, this task is going to involve a multitude of skills, and I'm particularly strong with them.
Yeah, everybody happy?
Yep.
Excellent. Welcome to my team, everybody.
She has her own management style, very, very forward, says what she wants and doesn't really beat around the bush too much. She gets things done, and if things are going pretty tough, then she'll be the first one to rise to the occasion and not let anything around her really bring her down.
Yasmina's commercial experience kept her clear of boardroom battles, only once ending up in the firing line.
Of course, Yasmina's sort of brush with death came in week four in the cosmetics task.
It smells like tequila to me. Don't you think?
Tequila and dogs?
Tequila and dog flavour shower gel.
Paula, who was project manager, tasking Yasmina and Ben to do the costings, and yet they screwed up on it.
How much did you say?
The oils.
Oils.
Like a few quid. A few quid.
So I'll put a fiver for that.
Yeah.
It won't be any more than that now.
No. It was the end of the first day and we'd worked really hard to make the shower gel and the soap. And then Nick came in and he informed us that we'd overspent on the sandalwood.
How much do you think you spent on fragrances, for instance?
I've got the figures in front of me.
How much does sandalwood cost tequila, do you think?
£1,072 or something, isn't it?
So what would 450 grams...
450 grams?
Thank you, mate.
No, half of 450...
Would it surprise you to know you've spent over £700 off? Goodness sake.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, I'll leave it with you.
From that moment on, I thought, oh, no, either I'm going to get fired or she's going to get fired. It was such a horrible moment. I felt sick. It's a horrible situation to be in. Knowing that I was going to have to be strong to stick up for myself in the boardroom.
She was brought into the final boardroom with Paula, her friend, because they were quite close, even though it was only week four. But I suppose she had to learn the lesson that when you're in front of the firing squad, you've got to look after yourself.
Yasmina, what's your opinion on this?
In my mind, that was a mistake that I made. I shouldn't be judged on the mistakes I make, but I should be judged on how I deal with those mistakes, OK?
Yasmina is very quick to turn on people.
As project manager, somebody should have taken overall responsibility of the costs, and that wasn't done. And I'm saying that it was your responsibility to either do that or delegate that properly.
I did delegate it.
Not properly, Paula, you didn't. So if it's me, myself and Paula, I'm going to have to say that Paula should be fired. At the end of the day, no matter what, we're here to win. And you might want to make friends along the way, but when it comes down to it, that friendship doesn't mean anything compared to your desire to get the job. I had to turn on her, I had to, because he said, turn around to me and he said, Yasmina, who do you think I should fire? And I looked at her and I was just like, sorry mate, and she was like, that's fine.
You did what you had to do.
I did what I had to do, and I'd do it to anybody really. Do you know what I mean? We're all here for one reason. Let's just get on with it.
That ruthless drive has swept Yasmina to victory 5 times.
So, your treat in return for this victory.
3 as project manager.
Winning is fantastic, you get great treats and it means that you're good at what you do. However, the flip side of that coin is that you don't get to spend enough time in the boardroom with Sir Adam, which is valuable time to find out what your weaknesses are.
I think Yasmina really wants to win this process. And although she has her own business, I think she does want to be an apprentice and learn. It's very tough if you start a business on your own. You've got nobody to sound off ideas on, nobody to go to for advice. And I think that's what she wants. She's got a lot to learn, and she wants to learn it from him.